Hello, I'm Dr. Dipshita Ghosh, your faculty for endodontics. Today, we'll have some discussions on MCQs. Let's have the first question. First question is, most useful in differentiating between an apicalepsis and a periodontal abscess would be option A, anesthetic test, option B, palpation, option C, palpation test, option D, pulp vitality test. In anesthetic test, what do we do? We used to anesthetize the specific tooth, and then we used to find out the result, which one is affected. In palpation, we can see either with your finger or with the help of the end of the mirror, the help of the mirror, then we can see the palpation part. Then in percussion test also, either apically or periodontally, we used to percuss the tooth. Then in pulp vitality test, with the electric pulp tester or with some frozen ice, we used to see the pulp vitality test. So what will be the correct answer in this? See, in anesthetic test, we cannot differentiate between apicalepsis and in periodontal abscess. Same here also in palpation, both can give the same result. In apicalepsis also you can get pain, in periodontal abscess also we can get pain. So we cannot differentiate. Same here in percussion also, but I think in pulp vitality test we can easily differentiate between this apicalepsis and periodontal abscess. In apicalepsis, what happens, the tooth may be non-vital, but in case of periodontal abscess, it's not necessary that the tooth will be non-vital. So the answer will be pulp vitality test. Your answer will be pulp vitality test, because in this we'll see the condition of the pulp, and we can say either the pulp is vital or not. So this is the answer. Answer is option D. Then second question, tenderness on percussion of a tooth indicates option A, extension of pulpal disease or infection into the periapical area, option B, the presence of a cementoma, option C, the presence of cyst, then option D, presence of granuloma. So what will be your answer? See, in case of cementoma, cyst and granuloma, tender on percussion is not evident. Sometimes you may not get any tenderness on percussion. But in case of any pulpal disease or infection in the periapical area, definitely you will get some tenderness on percussion. So your answer will be option A. So the tenderness on percussion of a tooth indicates extension of pulpal disease and infection of the periapical area. So answer is option A. Coming to the next question. Excessive mobility is found in acute abscess, option A, option B, severe periodontal disease, option C, root fracture, option D, all of the above. In acute abscess also, there can be mobility, and definitely in severe periodontal disease, there is bone loss, there will be mobility. Root fracture also same, so answer will be all of the above. It's very simple and easy question. Your answer will be all of the above. We can find mobility in abscess also, in severe periodontal disease also, in root fracture also. In root fracture, suppose this is the tooth, and if it fractures here, then this part will be movable. So here also you can get some mobility. So answer will be all of the above. This is your answer. All of the above. Going to the next question. Electric pulp tester most frequently employ which of the following kinds of current? Option A, Faradic, option B, high frequency, option C, low frequency, option D, none of the above. What happens during use of pulp tester, electric pulp tester, if we give high frequency, there will be too much of discomfort, too much of pain. First of all, we'll start with the low frequency, then we'll increase the frequency. So your answer will be low frequency. Electric pulp testers most frequently employ which of the following kinds of current? Answer is low frequency. We cannot give high frequency or Faraday because it will be of discomfort to the patient. So your answer is low frequency. Coming to the next question, the electric pulp tester is reliable only for the differential diagnosis of atrophic degeneration, option A, option B, calcific degeneration, option C, fibrous degeneration, none of the above. in this atrophic degeneration and then calcific degeneration and fibrous degeneration, we will get false negative result. So your answer is option D, none of the above. In all of these three, we will get false negative result. False negative. Remember this. Next question. Radiolucent areas appearing over or around the maxillary central apices could be option A, bilateral anterior palatine foramen, option B, a globulomaxillary cyst, option C, a median anterior maxillary cyst, option D, a single anterior palatine foramen. Okay, let me draw something here. Suppose this is the maxilla, these are the tooth. Here we will get the nasolabial cyst. Here we will get the median anterior maxillary cyst. Okay. So radiolucent areas appearing over or around the maxillary central apices. Just note this point, apices. So if the tooth is here, apical part will be here. So if we get radiolucent area in the apical area, then it will be a median anterior maxillary cyst. So answer is number C, point C, median anterior maxillary cyst. Remember this diagram, then you can easily identify. In the apical part only, you can see the radiolucency in case of anterior, median anterior maxillary cyst. Coming to the next question, diagnosis of a tooth with exposed vital pulp and an incomplete deformed root is made by option A, clinical findings, option B, raw antigenographic evidence, option C, clinical findings and raw antigenic evidence, option D, subjective symptoms alone. So in clinical findings, let me read the question again. Diagnosis of a tooth with exposed vital pulp. The pulp is vital and it is exposed and the root is incompletely formed. Suppose it's like this, the apices is not closed. Root is incompletely formed, but then it is exposed. Suppose somewhere here, fracture or fracture is somewhere here. So clinically, we cannot see this part. If we take X-ray, then we can be sure about this incomplete formation of root. So clinically, even if there is pain, we cannot identify this part. So what will be your answer? Any guess? See, both clinical findings and X-rays, raw antigenographic evidence. We have to see both. Not only the clinical findings will make us sure about the diagnosis. So you have to find both the clinically and raw antigenographic evidence, that is X-rays. Okay, so your answer is this one, C. Answer is C. Very easy. Then coming to the next question, electric pulp testing. Option A has no limitations. Option B is not a reliable method for determining the state of pulp vitality. Option C measures the sensory nerve response to irritant of electricity. Option D reveals that a recently erupted tooth is vital. Pulp testing has so many limitations. Sometimes it gives false positive. Sometimes it gives false negative result because of its limitations. So option A we cannot take. Option B, you cannot say that this is not a reliable method. Sometimes it's very reliable. So option B we cannot take. Measures the sensory nerve response to irritant of electricity. In this theory of pulp testing only you can find it measures the sensory nerve response to irritant of electricity. So your answer is C. And if we discuss the option D, it reveals that a recently erupted tooth is vital. No, it cannot reveal whether the tooth is vital or not. This pulp testing method cannot reveal. So your answer is, in electric pulp testing, it measures the sensory nerve response to irritant of electricity. Next question again on electric pulp tester. It always elicits a satisfactory response in multi-rooted tooth? No, This is the limitation of pulp tester again. So this cannot be the answer. This cannot be the answer. It cannot give 100% accurate result in multi-rooted tooth. Option B is used to test teeth with full coverage of crown. It is very difficult if the tooth is covered with a metallic crown, then we can get false positive result. False positive. Because the metal is heat conductor. Metal itself is a conductor, so it will give false positive result. Then option C, register disease of the pulp. Yeah, this point you can take, because pulp tester we used to find the vitality of the pulp. Vitality of pulp. So definitely it will register the disease of the pulp.